Hello guys and welcome back. So this is the render that we've got, and I think it's pretty cool. I see a lot of cool details, and I canceled the render. It's only this section that finished rendering, and so far I think it looks great. And if we crank up the gamma, you can see there's all kinds of cool reflection. These nice golden pieces are picking up highlights and all. This didn't finish rendering, so it's still the same. And if we take a look at the 2.2 gamma version, the sRGB, again, I think everything is pretty clean, not so much noise in there. So we're going to continue. And I think the next part that I want to focus on or bring up is these curvatures. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place a light here and shoot the rays upward and then control the fall off nicely, so it doesn't hit all the way up. It's not too intense. I just want to create a nice gradient. So I'm going to take this light and copy it. I'm going to call this roof left, and let's rotate it. Let's see. Yeah, 90 degrees. And let's move it up and in. I'm gonna scale it so it covers from here to here. And the bigger the area light, the more diffused the lighting is going to be. Let's move it down. Okay. Let's copy this name. I'm going to lower the settings, 960 by 540. And I'm going to lower the number of threads. Let's do 120. So we can have something for the recording. It was stepping a while back. It was lagging. Okay, let's hit render, and I'm gonna actually add only that light. Cool, so I didn't have to click again. And you can see we're getting now this nice gradient. It's capturing all these, it's already almost there. I like the color as well, but I'm going to add more purple, and let's reduce its intensity. I think it's too strong. Let's try 600. Something like that. I'm gonna desaturate the color. Yep. Perfect. Okay, let's make a copy of this. Delete. And let's move this guy. There. Okay. Cool. So if we look here, these pieces are crucial to the visual of the scene. These guys. So I'm going to create an area light and place it in one of the boxes, in one of the motifs, and then we'll go into duplicate that for all of them. And I think it's very important to add that now so we can have something in there at the moment. And I'm going to copy this and call this motif big source. And I'm going to make sure that the attenuation, I don't need to use the map. We don't need the attenuation to be high. I'm going to give it a complementary color, and let's reduce its size to 2x2. Actually, let's do it all the way here. So when we copy it, it it's easy for us to push. Okay, I think. Let's move it in further. And let's make it bigger. Like that. I don't want it to leak out or anything. And I'm gonna copy this motif small source. I want one for the smaller ones as well. 2x2. And I'm going to create a new camera. Let's create a new camera. And let's make sure that's what we're using. So let's give these guys a different color. And let's add them. Let's change the camera to 2. And let's hit render. And I'm going to increase the intensity quite a lot. In case, so we can see if there is any leaking or anything. We can see it now. Okay, cool. So everything looks good. Let's try 100. Nice. By 100. And let's switch the camera to 1. And we have to render again. Nice. And I'm gonna lower the active radius as low as possible, so it doesn't exit this, basically. I just want it to stop right after it hits that. I think 12 is 20. Yeah, 12 looks good. And this guy, let's try 600 because it's a smaller area. 300. And let's saturate one of them more to bring the difference even more. Ah, cool. Something like that. And the radius for this, let's try 8. Is good. Okay, so let's copy this. And we're gonna just duplicate them by hand. So I'm going to create a null, and we're going to do the copying of these groups by hand. I think we can use the back view. Yeah, it's hard to see. So let me do this. To get proper feedback, I'm gonna go inside this DRA instancing and just see one group, which is hopefully where the lights are. No, it's the other one. So this guy. Okay. And I'm also going to switch this DRA. Instead of loading the low res, I'm gonna display the high res. So now we have full preview. Let's look at the camera from this angle. Let's turn off the grid. I'm gonna copy this to fill the extra one. I didn't see it. And let's copy this. Okay, so that's fine. And we moved it 12. And once we have a couple, it will be much, much faster. Okay, I think, yep, so we're there. And I'm going to copy this. And I'm going to connect a null for all of them. For all these guys. And let's go to the viewer. And let's scale them -1. And then let's turn on the copy. Yeah, I think displaying the high res version is fine, so we'll keep the high res in this case. And it looks like we have the lights in there. So let's just double check. Cool, and then these guys. Okay. All right, let's see. So we named them motif, and I'm gonna type in motif star. If we click here, it's gonna select all of them nicely, so we can use that instead. Let's go to the render view and hit render, and let me switch this back. And it looks like here we're not gonna see them. And that one is leaking, so we'll keep it, because the camera, we're gonna remove this area anyway, or we can add a copy and push everything one unit. Okay, and let's make sure this is working, the other angle. So I'm gonna take this camera and cam 2, let's hit render. We may have to swap or inverse the emission, because we inversed them. No, that's not the case. Everything looks good. Okay, so now we've brought those up. And I think the next part for us is to bring the arches out. So these guys. And what I'd like to do is I want to create a gradient that starts bright here and fades off quickly to bring these guys to our attention. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to copy this. I'm going to call this arch left. And let's rotate it. I'm going to move it all the way in, but up to this point. And let's scale it down. Something like that. Let's move it down. Cool. And let's take a look at this from Cam 1. Nice. So in terms of color, I'm gonna do a few things. I want the arch light to emit on both sides. I don't want it to be single-sided, so I want to get lighting inside the arch itself and outside. And I'm going to change the blue, yeah, something like that, to a more desaturated color. And let's make sure the attenuation is working nicely. Cool. Everything is working. Okay, so what I would expect from these guys, if they're this strong or of this intensity, even though the decay is here, I can stop it to there. Or there. Yeah. So 12. 14 is good. Even though the attenuation stops at there, in reality they would be bleeding out and hitting this corner, if not this area. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fake the GI of this section. Okay? And the way I'm going to do that is using another area light. So area left GI. I'm going to move it out and rotate it. I'm going to move it here. I don't have to rotate it because my plan is to have it emit on both sides. And let's see how that looks. Yeah, this is very cool already. And because of its visual presence, it's very important that this element contributes to global illumination somehow. And right now, see, it's not hitting this section. And so I'm going to go up. Let's make sure first the attenuation is pretty high. So yeah, so it was the attenuation. So we're good. I'm gonna lower it back to, let's say, something like that. I really love this part. I'm gonna try and keep it. Let's try 20, 60. Yep, 60 is good. Let's try 40. Yeah, 40 is good. I don't want to hit the ground. I don't want it to get there, but I want it to hit these guys. Yeah, 35. And I'm going to desaturate the color and lower the intensity, of course, to 100. Because I don't want to steal the importance of these. And a cool thing now, what we can do is we can saturate this color more so it comes up even, it's more present in the scene. And I think there's too much discrepancy there. Yeah, something like that. This is very cool. And I'm going to tweak this. I'm going to set it to 40. And I want it to get that nice fall off, but I don't want it to be too bright when it gets to the ground. So I changed this to 40, and I'm going to do something different. I'm going to change how the light decays by hand. I'm going to set it to 60. See, it's getting brighter here. Let's try 80. So it's hitting the ground. 60, I think. And I'm going to increase the value here so it gets brighter further away from the source. See, now this part is cleaner, is more visible, and I can move this like that. I don't want to hit the ground. Okay, cool. So we have these two guys. Let's copy them. And I'm going to create a reference of these two like that, and then I'm going to create a null. Let's see if this works. And with this, I'm going to just scale them in a negative minus one, and that should mirror them perfectly. This light is very close to the statue hand, which could be tricky. So I'm going to rotate this slightly. So it's, we'll see how that looks. And I need to add them. pretty cool. I think it's too bright in here, so in this area. So I'm gonna lower it to 50. Yeah, something like that, definitely. And let's add everything we've done, except the environment light. And see what we have. So everything looks good. I think this color is too strong compared to everything else. So let's tweak that. That would be sky. Yep. No, not sky, the roof. So this color is not working well. Something like that. I'm gonna lower it. I also want to convey bottom bright, top darker as it travels through. So this is better, and I think this color is very bright. So I'm going to lower that as well. And let's desaturate it more. Cool. And I'm gonna move the camera in. I don't want to see this this section. Cool. Okay, what else do we have? Now if we look at the scene, we have everything lit almost in this area, but we don't have any anything from outside. As if we have an environment, obviously we don't have any source coming in and bringing light. The what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a light behind the camera as if this is an open scene, except the back. Once we add the rest of the scene, the back, we can we're gonna light that separately. But behind the camera, I want to add another source that is bringing a different color, a different it has a different contribution to the scene, and also help illuminates hopefully this part, which is the my biggest worry at the moment. And then we don't have any fills in here, so we're gonna fix some of that, and hopefully once we add this, we're gonna have more source to reflect and illuminate this. And let's see, so let me think, what we're missing at the moment is a fill for all these sides. And I think it would be nice to, because there is a lot of reflection, there is a lot of GI here, I think it would be nice to add an area light that shoots up with a desaturated color, just to add an overall fill to the scene, because all this global illumination will bounce back and create a lot of illumination. This color is very, very cool. This complementation is very cool. This is very cool as well. So my biggest worry at the moment is these areas. And let's add the light from behind first, and then we'll go from there. So let's, okay, let's copy this. I just need a light. I'm gonna call this back sky. It's not sky, but white color. Let's move this. And in terms of scale, it's at 60 by 60. To set it to 0, and let's move it. I'm gonna rotate it like that and scale it so it covers the whole scene. Cool. And I'm gonna give it a different color, this time a purple color, and let's call this let's add it. I cut that list and paste it here in case we wanted to restore that in the exclude list. And let's make sure the render settings are low. Okay, so that's our light. Let's turn off the attenuation, see how far it gets. Don't need that. Nice. I actually like this attenuation. I like it hitting all the way to the end, and see how cool these details are. Now, definitely. Okay, let's add those lights back in and see how we can balance it with this. We don't have to. I think everything is balanced. This contrast is very cool as well. Now that I'm looking at it, this part feels very, very uniform. I'm gonna lower this intensity. And that would be RGI, set it to 10. Yeah, because I definitely like this gradient a lot more. And maybe let's give it a warmer color. Okay. And then one last thing I'm going to do is see, we don't have any more fills. All this is dark now. I'm going to add an area light in the center. And let's copy this. That's fine. I'm going to set it to 0. I'm going to move it here. Once we have the character in, we may have to change a few things. I'm going to rotate it and move it up so it doesn't hit the character. I'm going to scale it down like that. Scale it up. Center fill. Gonna add it with everything else and tweak it. I'm gonna turn off its attenuation and let's hit render. Now see, this color feels very, very desaturated. I wanna warm it up. I wanna add more orange to this, maybe even more warmer than this. Cool, so see, now we have lights everywhere from that area light, and it's too strong at the moment. And let's set it to 200. I think this is working. 200 is good. And maybe less. This is too bright. Yeah, something like that. And hopefully we'll have some more lights here to eliminate these guys. And I think I'm gonna lower this even more, because now we added some more area lights. I may have to lower that. It feels very a bit flat here, so I want to create more contrast there. And those are the arch lights. So let's find them. Yeah, much better. The GI. Yeah, it's not working for me. This is too bright. Let's see what's causing that. so the back is causing some of that. I'm going to desaturate the back. Yep, much better. And see, all this mixture now is really cool. Okay, let's do one more thing. This hull, I'm going to use the search. Hull left, I'm going to make it warmer. Boom. This is very different than the one I did, for sure. Okay, I think, I need to stop here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cancel. I'm going to increase the resolution a bit. Increase the settings to 0.7. No other changes. I'm going to include the this section, which is stairs, door, statue main, statue left, and these guys. So we can do that together. Okay, that's it. Render. And we may have to tweak a variety of things because we didn't worry too much about that geometry, but it's been affected by all this light. So M-Play is a little bit dark compared to this. There's, I think, 1.1 difference in terms of gamma. So it's much nicer here. It looks like I needed that light back in. Cool. This is very, very cool. So I think the center needs some more attention here, especially that there is nothing to reflect. This statue is very bright and the hand is intersecting. This is cool. I'd like to get some more gradient here. You know, if we move the light up, we can change its decay and have it really strong here and falls off quickly. But maybe you guys can explore some of that. So this center needs a lot of work. This part needs a lot of work. And even with all this tweaking and everything, there is another pass that we're going to do in comp. This is very cool. I didn't get this before. I love this shadows and intersection. Very, very cool. Nice warm colors. So even with this, we're going to get AUVs per light AUVs, and we can control the... We can break everything into passes and change the color of every single light in comp. So we still have plenty of things that we can do to improve this or try different lighting scenarios. Pardon me. The other thing that we could do, if we see noises like this, we can find which light is causing most of that, and then pardon me, and then debug that and increase the light sampling for that light specifically without affecting everything else. This is very bright, so we're gonna reduce the intensity of this as well. It's the same shader, it's just a white diffuse with reflection, but it's cool that it's picking up all this cool stuff. Yeah, this looks nice. Okay, so we're done here. We're going to continue adding lights for this area. Now we're going to light the center, and then we're going to add some lights to fill in anything where we see issues like these guys here. I was thinking of adding extra light, like a thin light here that shoots in this direction, and then have another light inside, like a point light, illuminating the whole section. I think that could be really cool. Maybe we'll try it. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.